Hey there, I'm Jake with Nextiva, and in this video, we're gonna dive into the difference between a sip line and a sip trunk. We got a lot of information to drink up. Well, let's get sipping. To get to the root of the differences between sip lines and a sip trunk, we need a bit of understanding of what a sip protocol is and how it works. SIP stands for Session Initiation Protocol, and it's used to initiate voice, text, and video calls across the internet. It's a great way to either bring your existing analog phone investment to the cloud, or to build a completely modern phone system from scratch using both hard and soft phones. VoIP can exist on SIP, but SIP adds text, video, and multimedia messaging in addition to voice over IP to its protocol. SIP systems allow you to balance the demands of bandwidth, line use, and cost. They also give you the opportunity to bring existing investments in telephony to the cloud. Think of it like a magical Thanksgiving dinner where all the boomers and teens in your life speak the same language and get along just fine. Oh, that sounds wonderful. So what is a SIP line? Each SIP call requires a channel or session. We call this a SIP line, and it's analogous to a traditional phone line. One call requires one line. Think of lines like lanes on a freeway. Just like the lanes keep you from impacting other cars, SIP lines help to segregate traffic to ensure that each call has adequate bandwidth and call quality. SIP trunking groups SIP lines together to create a connection to an organization's phone provider via the internet. Since not all organizations require a dedicated line for each user, SIP trunking allows you to combine SIP lines to route traffic on demand. This reduces the need for additional lines and increases cost efficiency while maintaining existing hardware investments. Grouping SIP lines into a trunk allows organizations to control costs and availability. SIP trunk costs generally correlate to the number of lines needed, so the more lines required, the more cost. A call center might require 300 lines, and all those lines may need to be used simultaneously. Contrast that with a 300-person corporate office, where only perhaps 15% of the team uses the phones concurrently. The call center may need a 300-line SIP trunk, where the corporate office may be able to take a smaller SIP. With 45 lines serving the same amount of employees, the corporate office can take a small SIP while the call center chugs away like Otis on the Andy Griffith Show. Think of SIP lines as branches of a tree or lines in a freeway. SIP lines come together to create a SIP trunk, and the trunk is what connects via the internet to your communications provider. Utilizing SIP lines allows you to easily scale from your current investment in hardware. It gives you ease of setup and low maintenance. SIP trunking allows for flexibility and cost efficiency by allowing you to scale up quickly and reduce dedicated lines. And it may bring the boomers and teens in your life just a little closer. If you're ready to upgrade to a modern cloud-based business communication system, Nextiva is here to help. Check out the links in the description for more info on our products and services. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.